amazing, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how to make these really awesome terracotta pot candy jars. So these are super, super easy to make. I've been wanting to make these for like 6 years and I never did it, and I wish I had because they're really, really simple to make. So I've broken this video up into two parts. The first part just shows you how to make the jar itself and everything that you're going to need, but I'll also show you guys how I decorated these to make them look like candy corn. I've also made extras that I'm going to be selling on Etsy. You can see that's why I've got a cute little tag on it and everything. And you can see some more behind me. But yeah, I'm super excited. These are perfect for like fall or Halloween or Thanksgiving because they are just candy corn, which is really cool. So let's go ahead and get started. So I'm gonna start by showing you guys what you're gonna need for the candy jar. So I'll show what I use to decorate these with also, but if you guys are just gonna decorate it your own way, this is all you need to make your basic candy jar. So we're gonna need a 6-inch terracotta pot, a 6-inch terracotta saucer, a glass bowl, and this one here is from Dollar Tree. So yeah, this bowl here, I did get it at Dollar Tree for $1. I love this bowl. It was the perfect size for these 6-inch terracotta pots. And again, they're about like 4 by 5 inch bowls. If you can't find them at Dollar Tree or you just want to get them somewhere else. But if you're looking for just kind of like the specs on this bowl, you can definitely look down in the description. There's a link to Dollar Tree, so you guys can kind of go check them out and see what you're looking for. But yeah, really cool. Love these glass bowls. And then we're gonna need some wooden knob or any kind of knob that you wanna use, and some E6000 glue. So we're gonna start by taking the stickers off of the terracotta pot and the saucer. We're also gonna take it off of the glass bowl. When you're taking stickers off of glass, usually they can be pretty annoying, so just use a little rubbing alcohol to kind of rub off the sticker. Next, I'm gonna flip the terracotta saucer upside down. We're gonna apply some E6000 to the flat end of the wooden knob and place that wooden knob in the center of that saucer. Next, we're gonna apply the E6000 to the rim of the bottom of the terracotta pot. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna place that glass bowl onto the bottom of that pot, right where that glue is. So now we finish with our candy jar. You can allow that E6000 to dry for at least 24 hours before decorating. So I'm gonna be making mine look like candy corn, which is really awesome for like Thanksgiving and fall and Halloween, whatever you wanna use it for. Are you done? So what I'm gonna use is I'm gonna use some yellow, orange, and white paint. Yellow, white, and orange glitter, some Mod Podge, paint brushes, cardstock, scissors, hot glue, white ribbon, a pen, and an X-Acto knife. So now what we're going to do is we are going to paint our candy jars. So I'm going to start with my yellow paint. This is Sunny Day by Apple Barrel. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to paint the knob on my lid yellow. And then I'm going to paint the bottom, like base, of the candy jar yellow as well. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and get my white paint, and this is just a white Apple Barrel paint. I'm going to paint the entire top layer of our candy jar white. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my orange paint. This one is Pumpkin Orange by Apple Barrel, and I'm going to paint the lid orange, and I'm also going to paint the center section of my candy jar orange. So next what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna write "Got Candy" on my candy jar. And again, I wrote "Got Candy" on these because I didn't wanna just use them for like Halloween and write "Happy Halloween," or use them for Thanksgiving and write "Happy Thanksgiving." I wanna use these for all of fall. So I just put "Got Candy" on it. It just seemed like a cute little thing to write on there and just goes with the candy corn feel of it. So we're gonna get our white paint, and I would normally just do this freehand, but because I was making extras to sell on Etsy, I made my own like little stencil just so I could have them all look exactly the same. But yeah, so I'm just gonna write "Got Candy" with white paint on the orange section of my candy jar. And the next one I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get out my Mod Podge and I'm gonna coat the words "Got Candy" in a Mod Podge and then place on some white glitter while it's still not dry. And then we're gonna allow that to dry so that we've got nice glittery text. So next I'm gonna make my candy corn decorations. Now, I know that you can probably just buy like little candy corn decorations somewhere, but I only needed 2 per candy jar. I just didn't feel like going out and buying any, and I just think that these ones just look so cute and glittery when you make them yourself. So first I'm gonna grab some cardstock and draw a candy corn on it with my pen. Then I'm going to fill in that shape with some hot glue. Then I'm gonna paint my candy corn. So I'm gonna use the same paints that I used for my candy jar. So I'll use white at the top, yellow at the bottom, orange in the center. But this time I'm gonna apply Mod Podge to each of these sections and use a matching glitter on them. So where I painted white, I'll add on some Mod Podge and attach white glitter. I'll do the same for the yellow with some gold glitter and attach on some orange glitter with the Mod Podge in the orange section that I painted. So basically we're just gonna make this whole thing looks super glittery, and then what we're going to do is I will add on a layer of Mod Podge and cut them out with an X-Acto knife. Next, all I need to do is just hot glue on my candy corns. So next I'm going to coat the lid and the candy jar, except for the bowl part, with Mod Podge to seal in that paint. Once I'm done with that, I'm going to get my white ribbon. I've just made a little bow out of my ribbon, and I'm just going to attach it to the front of my candy jar using some of that E6000. So now all we need to do is place our candy corn into a glass bowl and place the lid back on. Here you can see another candy jar that I made. This was my first prototype one, so I've been using this one around the house, and I put my favorite fall mix in it, which is candy corn, Reese's Pieces, and peanuts, and yeah, I absolutely love it. But again, I've been using this one, kind of just feeling it out, see how well everything holds, and it's been working perfectly. It's just so cute. I absolutely love it. If you guys would like to see the step-by-step instructions on how I made these, you can look down in the description. There's a link so you guys can see the pictures or pin it on Pinterest and save it for later. Also, I do have some of these. As you can see, the ones with the tags and the ones behind me are going to be for sale on Etsy. Really awesome. I'm very excited about these. I want everybody to have one because they're just so cute. But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Whether you want to make your candy jar look like candy corn or you just want to decorate it another way, I hope this video helped you. So, I still don't know how to end this video, so bye!